We've all been in these situations, right? It's the mid-game, we're boxed up, and we're just trying to make it to the end. When suddenly, some guy just glides in, runs up, and starts whacking at your wall, thirsty for your loot. Whenever we're just trying to play passively, mind our own business, this type of player can just be the worst. Trust us, we know. If I seem a little emotional, I am, because it's annoying. So if they bug you too, don't worry. It actually turns out that if you know the right way to defend yourself, they're not too hard to take care of after all. What's going on, guys? It's your guy. That's right, your friend. You know I'm back. It's Keith Allen. What's the deal? What's going on? Listen, hey, I want to let you know right now, I'm your number one fan. I really am. I'm really cheering for you guys. I'm rooting for you guys that this is going to be the greatest time of your life. So let's just take advantage of this, man. Take advantage of this. Keep grinding. Don't give up. And don't ever say the two words, I can't, together. Okay? You can. You can. All right? So connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram. I would love to hear from you. So today we're going to be talking about the best ways you could put a stop to aggressive players. Did you hear what I said? It's time to deal with these people once and for all. I hope you're ready for that. We're going to start by going over some of the most effective ways to find opening and deal damage against them. Then we're going to talk about defensive tips and what you should be doing to buy more time in inbox fighting scenarios. And lastly, towards the end of the video, a couple of simple but important tips that can stop you from being pushed in the first place. But before we get into that, we have to ask you guys this. Show your love to pro guys by smashing that like button. It only takes a couple seconds, if you're like really slow, maybe like 3. And it really helps us produce these videos, guys. So more videos, it's gonna make you better. So it is a win-win situation if you think about it. And we also noticed that most of you guys don't visit our website. What's going on? Come on, man. Show us some love. You guys are missing out, I'm telling you. Because we just added all new analysis videos and trending articles along with new courses coming with the World Cup Pros and much more. Okay, so click that link and check us out. All right, so whenever you're being pushed by a super aggressive player, you know who they are, you can't really just sit there and just turbo build forever. You could maybe do that before the changes if your ping was good enough, but nowadays, your wall is going to get taken sooner or later. So at some point, you're gonna have to respond with something, okay? You gotta do something, please, anything. And usually, the quicker and more unexpected your response is, the better. All right, so let's just say somebody is swinging at your wall, all right? So the first thing you wanna do is you wanna be like, what, huh? You swinging at my wall? And just get psycho and just start dancing and just getting crazy and just take off your shirt, throw it at the screen. I'm playing, don't do that. It's a joke, I'm joking, okay? What you really need to do is, cause that'd be crazy, okay, don't do that. First, you need to take note of what they're standing on, all right? Did they place a ramp, a cone, or are they on a floor piece? Now, if they're on a floor piece, you always have the option to edit your wall, ramp over them and box them in. If you have a trap, you can place it on the ceiling and reverse your ramp to deal an easy chunk of damage. Without a trap, you can always stay in your box and edit the ramp for a better, safer angle. But if you're really crazy, like me, I'm a little crazy, I can admit that, you can hold the edit to reverse your ramp, run up it, and confirm the edit to drop down right beside your opponent. Now, we only recommend this if you're going to have control in the pieces in that box, as you normally wouldn't just want to place yourself in an enemy trap territory. And also another thing is you probably have to be a little crazy, okay? But just keep your shirt on and don't throw it at the screen, because I was just joking, all right? Yeah. If they're on a cone or stair piece, you won't be able to just ramp over them. Boxing them in becomes a lot harder since they'll have a line of sight on you anytime you edit your wall. Instead, you can always go for a quick window or corner edit, making sure to stay behind the unedited portion, place a trap above them, and then quickly reset the wall. Most players are too focused on breaking your wall, they're not gonna even realize what happened. They're gonna be like, what's going on? When it comes to editing for a quick shot or trap, speed, my friends, is crucial. But what's equally important and often overlooked is also timing. You never wanna end up in the scenario where you go to edit, but then you can't because the enemy just took control of the piece. Ideally, you know, you wanna edit while your opponent starts the first swing. You can catch them with their pickaxe out, meaning you can get your gun out first. If you start before their first swing, you can edit without any worry of your wall being taken. Yes, that's a great feeling. If your wall is about to break, like within one swing away, always hold the wall, okay? We're gonna talk later in the video about how to respond when it does get taken, but for now, my friends, know that you should never give up your wall for free. Versus SMG or a rifle spam, you can always try to time a shotgun blast as soon as your wall breaks. You might take some damage in return, but as long as you line up the shot really nicely, a shotgun will always win the trade, my friends. Just make sure to immediately rebuild the broken wall after your shot for some cover. So to play it safe reverse SMG spam, stall by turbo building until they need to reload. Make sure to have a ramp for backup in your box just to prevent bullets from slipping through. Once they're out of ammo, well, it's all yours, my friends. You can just use the reload time to apply pressure of your own. Edit out for some shots, box them in, or try to take height. Okay, so check this out. If you got an SMG in your loadout, here's one trick that you can use that'll completely surprise your opponent. All right, listen up. Wait until the structure they're hitting starts to get low on health. Then pull out your SMG and just straight up go Rambo push on them like boo, 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 boo. It really doesn't sound like that. Can you imagine if the gun really made that noise? That would be disastrous. Anyways, they usually won't expect it, and you've got a good chance of catching them with their pants down. Not literally, but you know what I mean. That's disturbing. You can actually slip past the wall fast enough, and so it won't even matter if they take it. You're now spraying your SMG right in their face. They're not even gonna know what happened. This move can be kind of risky against better players, as there's always the potential of getting boxed in and trap killed. To minimize risk, we recommend only using this move if you know for certain they're low on health. Let's talk about what to do when you've got somebody pressuring your box from above. The most common move, guys, is to edit your floor and roof piece. Get close to your wall and go for a jump shot. Yeah. Because of the third-person camera, you'll be able to line up a shot from behind cover. And unless your opponent's peeking in really deep, they won't be able to react in time. But sometimes, your opponent will expect this shot and respond with either a wall or by keeping their gun out to trade. As with many other scenarios, you can juke them out first, edit the wall, and add a ramp to draw their attention. Then you can just go for the jump shot with less fear of getting hit back. Dang, these mind games are real out here, guys. What are we gonna do? Don't panic. We got this. We got this. Don't panic, guys. We got this, okay? Finally, before we get into the more defense-oriented tips, here's one last move you can use whenever your walls get taken. Honestly, this is one of the more underrated moves, and we only see a few pros even using this. Have a cone ready to edit into a ramp and let your wall get taken. When your opponent edits the wall, line up your crosshair, quickly reset your cone, and blast them with a meaty shotgun hit. Most players will be trying to pressure your cone after taking the wall and won't even expect the possibility of a shotgun hit. It is a ridiculously unexpected move that more players definitely need to start using. Alright guys, so even though a quick aggression can work wonders, sometimes the opportunity just doesn't present itself right away. You might still even need to heal up or buy more time to find an opening. And so knowing how to stay on the move while being pressured plays a huge role in fighting against WKers. Whenever your wall gets taken, you normally want to place a ramp in your box as soon as possible. This is your second line of defense, and it's going to stop the follow-up shotgun blast from hitting you. Or you can place a cone preemptively inside your box and quickly edit into a ramp for cover when needed. But once your wall does get taken and you place the ramp for cover, you gotta move. There are a few ways you could do this, okay? So the safest and easiest is to simply edit out the back of your box. You can edit out to the sides as well, but it's slightly riskier. Any fast-acting enemy is going to place their own wall as a part of your new box, but if you go out the back, they won't be able to. Editing down is also a great way to slip away from your opponent, but it's more situational and can't really be used when you're on the ground level. If you're looking to quickly take high ground, you can triangle edit one of your walls and do a side jump from your ramp. From here, you can crank up, that soldier boy, not playing. You can crank up or just box up again. If you need to end up building high, just be wary of what your opponent responds with, okay? They might try to contest height, at which point you gotta be ready to punish them. Or they might try to break your structures to drop you. If you notice that's happening, try to drop down and surprise them while they're busy breaking your builds. It can be hard to keep track of somebody on height, and so they likely won't even be able to respond fast enough. Anytime you edit out and create a new box, you're essentially resetting the scenario to regain control of all the pieces around you. It keeps your opponents on their toes and lets you find openings that wouldn't be possible if you stayed in the same box. Sometimes, you'll even want to expand just to create more room for yourself. Like, if you're even being spammed at with rifles from multiple players, the biggest mistake that you can make is not to expand. Even before the turbo building changes, this was a really bad idea. And now that replacing walls takes longer, it's even worse. Anytime you're being pressured by multiple opponents from a distance, you gotta expand your builds. Got to. Move around, you know, build multiple walls for cover and even build up a level if you can. It'll give time for your structures to gain health and your enemies will have a much harder time focusing you down. All right, lastly, just a couple of simple but very effective tips to help minimize aggression against you in the first place. All right, so the first tip is you gotta look around more. Seriously, you look like you're throwing a party and you're the only one there. You're the DJ and the guest. It's all about you. I know that doesn't make any sense, but that's what it looks like. Weird. Seriously, it's so surprising, but so many players don't do this enough. Being conscious and aware of what's around you is a vital part of Battle Royale. More often than not, aggression starts because your opponents spot you and they get a few tags in before you even realize what's going on. Like in this clip right here, this player could have easily spotted the sniper to his left if he was just looking around a bit more, but instead he was DJing his own party and he was the only one there, so you know that wasn't a good party. All it takes is a quick glance at your surroundings every 5 to 10 seconds, that's all you gotta do. Then he could have built and taken a fight that wasn't him just dying instantly. For real, I know it sounds simple, but it really does help. The second tip, my friends, is to utilize natural high ground whenever you can. Whether it's the early game and you're looking for kills, or it's the mid game and you just want to box up, positioning yourself on some sort of natural high ground is going to work wonders. I don't know about you guys, but whenever I see a base set up on a mountain, I think twice about pushing it. And that's how most players will react too. They don't want to commit a bunch of mats just to take an uphill battle, I get it. Because even if they do decide to push, you have the advantage. You can lay down a ton of shots while they work their way towards you. And if they manage to get close to you, you can always build up higher. Just make sure to use brick or metal when building your bases, with how weak wood is. Whew. Using it is just asking to get pushed. You remember when you were a kid and you heard of the story, The Three Little Pigs, right? Okay, well, don't let that happen to you. And when it comes to responding with edits, brick and metal give you so much more time. You don't need to make massive one-by-ones or anything like that. Just a couple of stories high is good enough. The natural high ground you're on is still enough to give you a huge edge if any player pushes you. So, to summarize this, guys, fast and unexpected attacks are the best way to punish aggressive players. You can easily edit for some shots if you time it correctly. Before your opponent's first pickaxe swing is usually the best time. Anytime you lose your wall or can't find an opening right away, place a ramp in your box and expand out the back. Either that or use it as an opportunity to take height. You can also prevent aggression by staying vigilant and aware of your surrounding. Positioning plays a huge role, guys. So always try to set up on natural high ground to keep yourself safe. Practice these techniques and you should be able to hop into your next match and outplay any of those W-keyers that get in your face. You'll be like, take that, W-keyers, yeah. Once again, this is your guy, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I hope you enjoyed this video and make sure to connect with me as soon as you can on my Instagram. I would love to hear from you and I just want to inspire you guys to be great because you are. You're great. So I hope you enjoyed this video again and you know the drill. Click that thumbs up and leave us a comment saying what you want to see next. All right, guys, we'll see you later.